It's a Joey Bravo Wake Up Show. Good morning and happy Wednesday. I'm putting my W up. Hello. You know, I would like to call this Wu-Tang Wednesday. And the reason I'm calling it that is because it is Wednesday and I love Wu-Tang. So I'm going to drop this beat on you. What do you think of that beat right there? That's my beat.
I like how you like,
That's my
this
beat.
Is a good beat.
That's a good beat. I get all wild and crazy up in this, man.
Get all excited about it.
I do. I mean, I love hip-hop. You know this. You know, I'm a hip-hop artist myself, a.k.a. the Lyrical Sound Demon. Look me up anywhere on social media and stuff
like that. In case you're wondering.
A little cheap push right there. But but no, I really do love hip-hop. And one of my favorite MCs of all time happens to be Three Stacks, a.k.a. Andre 3000 of Outkast.
Oh, and we talked about this before. Like, he is great.
Yeah, this is what's really cool about it is he just actually dropped a verse on a new Goody Mob track.
Yes, it's called No Cigar, and it's been a little bit over a year since he's dropped a verse on a feature. And
His features are fire.
And, like, it was so crazy because I, like, just stumbled on it because when I, like, my YouTube, like, I listen to hip-hop too, so, like, obviously YouTube will recommend you songs like, you know, you should listen to. And that stumbled across, but I thought it was an old song. So I didn't think much of it. And I was like, ooh, this is a good song. And I'm like, ooh, Andre 3000 back at it again. Mm-hmm. And then I saw the date and I was like, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
I'm like, this is just like today that this came out.
Yeah.
And I got so excited because I know we really just, like, we barely just talked about the whole versus battle with Tribe Called Quest.
And all of a sudden we get surprised.
And we get surprises. Because I remember we even said to her, like, you know, Andre 3000 dropped something. And I'm like, oh my gosh, maybe I should start saying stuff on the radio for it to come true.
I know, can I
get $1 million?
We should. I think it's because we're speaking it into the universe,
yes,
so therefore
it
becomes reality.
Yes, I would like $1 million. Yeah, $1 million would be good.
Yeah,
yeah.
I think we're gonna be millionaires.
I believe so.
I'm gonna go ahead and say it's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen.
I'm gonna go ahead.
If we can continue to do that, maybe we'll see.
if we're millionaires next week, then you'll know that when we speak something on the radio, we speak it into reality.
Yes, but no, I really liked it. It was so good, and the whole song itself was pretty good. I really liked it.
Oh yeah, one thing about Andre 3000 is he was so fashionable, man. Like, his style was like unorthodox. It was like any other rapper I've ever seen.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah, and it was so cool because, like, especially during that era of hip-hop, like, the fashion sense was pretty it wasn't, like, I'd say basic. It was pretty basic. Everyone, you know, like, the big coats and everything, mm-hmm. but he, like, liked to step out of
that
comfort.
He was, like, against the grain in every way.
And you can tell people are kind of like, because as a hip-hop artist in the 90s, you kind of had to portray a different perspective.
Like a rough, tough look.
So when you see someone like that, which, I mean, he pulled it off look every single time, so it wasn't
Well, that's the thing is, he made up for it with his hard bars.
Yeah, his hard bars. So you forgot what he was looking like.
And speaking of fashion sense, there is a fashion icon that is now one of the richest young ladies out there right now.
Yes, and she deserves every bit of it.
Riri does.
Also, too, Harry Styles is in a little controversy with a Vogue magazine most recently.
Yeah, speaking of fashion, we're going to get into it. Sipping on Tea with Leo Marie is up next.
Spill that tea, sis. Time for Sipping on Tea with Aaliyah Marie.
It's the Joey Bravo Wake Up Show, and Aaliyah, don't just stand there, strike a pose. Vogue.
You know, I love the Madonna song Vogue. I love the show Pose because they implement Vogue.
Oh,
like, that's the whole purpose of it. And every time my sister watched that show or even hear the song, I got to strike a pose.
I know people are tuning in to this segment in particular because we just posted a video of us voguing.
Yes, I hope you guys liked how we vogued.
I'm not the greatest of voguers, but I vogued.
Yeah, like, give us 1 through 10. 1 through 10, who had the better, you know, posture,
yeah.
You know, the little
slouch. Voguing poses.
Yeah, because that's what it's all about. You have to, like, when you grade someone on their voguing, you have to see how well they do it.
Let me know, was it Aaliyah Marie who won this voguing contest,
yes,
or was it me?
Yes.
It's on Facebook, it's on Instagram, check it out.
And you can be, you. If you don't want Joey, it's okay, you can say that. No one's gonna get mad.
I'm not gonna feel bad, okay? But I'm gonna feel bad, just so
and
let
I'm gonna
you know.
Try 10 times harder next week. Well, now that we're talking about Vogue, did you see that Harry Styles is the first male to be featured on the Vogue cover? And it's so cool, because I think it's so great just because Harry Styles himself, he's such a fashion icon in a sense. Like, he really loves it more than anything.
He looks like he's wearing an extended kilt.
Yeah, so what it is he's wearing a Gucci jacket with this long dress. But that's what it looks like, too. Like, it doesn't look anything too crazy. But the whole purpose of Vogue is to feature American lifestyle fashion. And so outfits like that, like, I didn't think like, oh, he's wearing a girl dress. I think like, oh, like that's what, like you said, like it's a kilt. Mm-hmm. Like that's what I thought in a sense. I didn't think much of it.
Well, he's from the UK.
Yeah, he's from the UK. So it's like, like that's what I kind of thought in a sense. But I was very excited to see him be featured on this cover because that's the first male to do so. And I think that will open many doorways for other males that whoever wants to do that. Because like I said, it features fashion. Like it's all about fashion. It's nothing like too crazy or too.
But there was somebody who posted something about it.
Yeah, so
that, right?
Everyone loved it, obviously, because Harry Styles from One Direction. So what's not to love about him? But the New York Times bestseller author Candace Owens, she's the one who doesn't like
she
it.
She was hate.
She was hate, hate,
she
hate.
Was sipping on that hater rate.
Yeah, she was sipping on that hater rate. So what people were more upset about was what she had tweeted. There is no society that can survive without strong men. It is an outright attack. Bring back manly men.
Well, there's still manly men
there's
out there.
There's still manly men out there.
Just because Harry Styles wore an extended kilt doesn't mean there's not manly men out there.
And so when she posted that, there were even celebrities that were backing him up. So you had like Olivia Wilde, you had Kathy Griffin, you had Jamila Jamil. Like you had all these people saying like, he is the manliest of men. Like how would you say he's not just because he's on a fashion cover magazine? Like, and I think the same thing too. Like, you know, fashion, it's not just for one person or the other. It's for everyone.
Yeah, it was just a fashion
statement. Yeah, it's just a fashion statement. It wasn't anything too crazy. I mean, he was very excited too because
there's no need to question his masculinity.
Yeah, because to be like the first male to be on something like that, that's a very good thing to do, you know, to like say, hey, I've got to
be.
Yeah, it's a big deal. Mm-hmm. So it was more of like, you know, I was able to do something that no one really thought they could do. Mm-hmm. So now that I did it, it opens doors for some other people to do it. And so she ended up like tweeting another tweet to kind of like pretty much rephrase what she said, but that didn't help even when she rephrased it. Like
she dug herself deeper,
and I think she wasn't sorry for it because she says, I meant bring back manly men. Terms like toxic masculinity were created by toxic females. Real Ooh. Women don't do fake feminism. Sorry, I'm not sorry.
Dang.
So this girl, like, she's like, I don't care. I'm going to say what I said. I'm going to say it again.
I'm not going to get in the middle of this. I'm just going to leave it at that. All I got to say is Harry got styles. But at the end of the day, we all know who's got more style. My girl, Riri.
Yes.
Hello. Now, I really have mad respect for this young lady because the empire she's built.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's just amazing.
That's a perfect example of an entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
But that's also a good example to, you know, celebrity who wants to pursue something other than what they are good at. Like, there's so many things you can do. You just have to put your mind to it and make that time for it.
Yeah.
And you can tell she does that.
Yeah, she does. She's very passionate about
work. Yeah, very passionate. First of all, like, for the Fenty Beauty line. Like, that has done so well since she started it back in 2017, and it only gets better and better every year. Like, she really does give it her all, and that's one thing, like, compared to other makeup lines, you know, you have like MAC and everything, cosmetics. With that one, like, she does take the time to make sure that her makeup is for everyone. That's why I love so much about her. But her music, I love even more. Like, before she started her makeup line,
she's
a good artist. And,
she's got,
you know,
some jams.
The times that we've talked about, I've always said, I want Rihanna.
That's
to
why I
drop,
always put in work.
Right? Because I've always said, I'm like, I want Rihanna to drop an album and I'll be okay. And, like I said on the radio, like, the more we say all this stuff and give it to the universe, it's going to bring back something to
Riri's
us.
Riri's going to drop a record and she's going to dedicate it to me. But, Riri, keep it on the low.
Yeah.
I got a lady.
Yeah,
all right.
You
got
to chill, okay? You can send some free makeup to me, though. But no, I'm so excited she's dropping another album. But who she's working with has got me even more excited, and that's Pharrell.
Oh, wow.
And, oh, I love Pharrell.
Is he going to be producing her next album?
He's producing it. And I love it so much because him as a producer.
Oh, remember that track they did together, Lemon?
Yes.
Fire.
Like, honestly,
fire.
I'm so glad she picked Pharrell because he is such a music genius when it comes to producing, because he doesn't just sing songs and does his thing. Like, he makes music too.
Yeah.
And that's, he's another example of entrepreneur. And he, you know what's crazy? He has like triplets.
He
has triplets.
I know that?
Yeah. He like, when
I bet you he's happy.
Oh, right. But he is very, you know, secretive about his life and everything. But he's very excited to be working.
What about those big hats, though?
Right. He's like, I want people to know. But he's very excited to be working alongside Rihanna because he even says this album that she's going to be dropping, it's not going to be like the other music you hear from her. It's going to be a totally different thing. And that's what I love, is to hear different.
Well, I'm excited for Riri. That's that $600 million woman right there.
And that's what's even more exciting, too, because she just got featured on the Forbes magazine for the America's Richest Self-Made Women. She made it on number 33. And compared to Kylie Jenner, she's actually real.
Wow. Hey, Rihanna, can I borrow $20?
I ain't want to gossip, so you